Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of What's New in Explore. This time we're focused all on the CLI. My name is Frank Kilcommins. I'm delighted to be joined by my colleague Yousaf. Yousaf, want to say hello to everyone?
Hey everyone, I'm Yousaf from the SmartBear Dev team. Pleased to be here.
Great, so we have some exciting updates that we're going to talk to you about today. The first one is the ability to import insomnia collections via the CLI into Explore. So what I have here is I have insomnia running locally. I have 7 requests here as part of my collection. I'm going to go into my collection, import-export option, export data, export my collection, choose to export all of those. That's going to export it as an Insomnia V4 and then hit done, and that will store it off to my file system. Then jumping over into the Explore CLI, you'll see that we have a new command called import insomnia collections, compatible with V4 of the insomnia exports. So if I run that command, passing in the path to that insomnia export, it will process those requests and import them as a space into Explore. And just to jump quickly over into SwaggerHub Explore, going to go to spaces. I now have this my collection space that's been imported, and these are all of the compatible requests that have come over from Insomnia, and they are available in Explore for me to start interacting with the APIs. We've also launched the ability to deploy standalone binaries for the Explore CLI, so you no longer need to have .NET installed as a prerequisite. So here you will see the release with all of the different architectures that we support. And I'll hand over to Yousaf to take you through what's possible.
So we're just going to show a video here. And this is taking our Explore CLI. So it's built for multiple different systems. My host machine is a macOS Apple Silicon. So we're downloading the macOS binary. We've got my session token and XSRF token in the shell, and we're going to export the spaces from the Explore CLI to my local machine. We've also composed some Docker images in the repository, so I'll show the contents of that. We'll then build that Docker image, and we'll run that with the same command. So we'll be utilizing the Explore CLI in a Docker container and running that same export command. I hope this is useful to you, because some of you may be using the Explore CLI, but you don't use .NET. So this allows you, with a couple of caveats, if you check the README, to be able to use it freely without .NET. So go forth and explore.
Exactly, and in our GitHub repo, you'll find all of the supported platforms, and you'll be able to, via the releases tag, get to all of the relevant binaries and install them onto your platform of choice. So thanks very much, everyone. Happy exploring.